Am I on?
You don't sound like it.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Good morning. I have just a couple of announcements to share with you outside of what you have in your bulletin so that you know. I would invite you to please read through the announcements so that you have an idea of what's going on. But I would like to highlight the following. There's a sign-up sheet in the back for poinsettias if you'd like to purchase one for Advent, which starts next Sunday. And so that's the beginning of our season. And so they're out there. Also, Wednesday evening, 7 o'clock here, Thanksgiving Eve worship. Please don't leave me alone. I'm my worst company. I have all these plans I make and can never do them. Then, if you would like any of the youth to purchase a gift for you from the Angel Tree, they will be going shopping 2 weeks from today. If you have any questions, thoughts, concerns, or you want to do that, contact Landon or Sarah there, and they will see to it that it gets done for you. And then in our prayers this week, we'd like to include the following. They're listed, but just an update on them. Lois Wilson is home from the hospital, so we're thankful for that. We pray for Lois as we go forward through this week. And then Ann Erickson, who's recovering at home as well. You know, they were getting ready to leave, and the day before they left, she ended up in the hospital with diverticulitis. And so she's home for a while, recovering from that, and they're still planning to go down there. And then Peggy Shenford, who's a friend of Lola Breed's, has been placed in hospice at the hospice house, right, Lola?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And so we want to remember Peggy in our prayers as well. Today is our consecration Sunday, where we will receive the following items. If you're a member of the women's group, there will be a basket placed up on the altar at the appropriate time so that you can place your thank offering box. Or maybe we'll send it here, depends upon how the ushers want to do that, it's up to them. And then we'll have an usher on either side. We'll be holding the plates for our time and talent sheets, as well as the pledge forms. We'll drop those in, and we'll receive those with prayer as we end this church year and begin next week our new church year. And so that's what I have for announcements. Are there any others to add? If not, I would invite you to rise and return to the baptismal font for a brief order for confession and forgiveness. Those words are found on the back cover of the hymnal, which is in front of the rack in front of you, and you'll find them there. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
St. John reminds us that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God,
we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may glide in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. For his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We turn at this time to our gathering hymn, Beautiful Savior.
Thank you.
Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Strength, the very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains shake in the depths of the sea.
Though its waters rage and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult.
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High.
God is in the midst of the city, it shall not be shaken. God shall help it at the break of day.
The nations rage and the kingdoms shake. God speaks and the earth melts away.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold.
Come now, regard the works of the Lord, what desolations God has brought upon the earth.
Behold, the one who makes war to cease in all the world, who breaks the bow, who shatters the spear, and burns the shields with fire.
Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Here ends our sharing of the psalm.
The epistle reading is from Colossians chapter 1, beginning with verse 11. May you be made strong with all the strength that comes from his glorious power, and may you be prepared to endure everything with patience, while joyfully giving thanks to the Father, who has enabled you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has rescued us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things in heaven and on earth are created, things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers, all things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one. The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, if you are the King of the Jews, save yourself. There was also an inscription over him, this is the King of the Jews. One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us. But the other rebuked him, saying, do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong. Then he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. He replied, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
I would invite the younger members to come forward as you're seated for the time for a children's sermon. The gallery right up here in the front. Morning. What did the horses say last night? What? Nothing. You don't. You can't talk horse. I don't know. I'm not a horse. Hey, do you know anything about kings and queens? About royalty? No, we don't, do we? You know why? Because we elect presidents, don't we? And senators, and representatives, and governors, and things of that sort. We choose who rules over us, who serves us, right, as the president. Did you get to choose who your mom and dad were? Nope, you didn't. You're stuck with that. If we lived in a country that had a king, you wouldn't get to choose the king either. You'd be stuck with him. And so we don't understand really what kings and queens are and what it means to have royalty. But royalty is very important in Jesus' day, and even after that, in some people, and still in some countries, kings and queens are very important. They play a really neat role sometimes. In some cultures, kings and queens live so that if something happens and their country gets overthrown, they're the ones who are in trouble, not the people who live there. Sometimes kings and queens fight, you know, they have wars. But today we are reminded that Jesus is our king. He's our royalty. You know what color kings wear? They do. Mm-hmm. And when they're, some of them wear another color called purple. That's the color of royalty for kings and queens. So today what I would like you to remember is simply this, that God chooses to be your God. That means he's royal. He is above us. Not so that he can be over us, but that he can protect us, okay? Remember today that your protection always is in God, right? He's royalty, your king. I thank you for coming up. Would you have a jelly bean or two and go back? And that would be wonderful. All we need to do is be playing this in the show, right? Dear fellow believers, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. I just have to say it. How about them cyclones?
How about them Hawkeyes?
We come to the end of our church year, and as we do so, we are left with the echo of Easter. That moment that begins with the crucifixion of Jesus and ends with his resurrection, which lives on into today. It's often a struggle to try and understand why they would use this text as we come to the end until you get to the very conclusion of that text. But before we get there, just a few items. In Jesus' day, they were expecting a king, a prince, a ruler, or somebody to ride in, as we would say, on a white steed wearing a white cowboy hat, the good guy, who is going to smite and put to death, first of all, the Romans, then any remaining Babylonians, anybody else who's ever caused them pain or harmed them or sent them into exile. They really wanted them crushed. The vision that ancient Israel had of the Messiah was one who was going to be in human form and destroy all the enemies of God. And that enemies list was in their hands. They chose who their enemies were. They'd forgotten their history, that God had used all of those nations as a way of correcting them and bringing them back to him. But instead, what they were looking for was for vengeance. They were looking for their wrath to be visited upon those people. And so they kept that enemies list near and dear to them. And they kept telling that story. But what they forgot about the story was that it was always rooted in God delivering them, God saving them from the enemy. Not the enemies out there, but the enemy within themselves. You remember how that goes? We have seen the enemy and he is us. And so by the time the church looks back, centuries later, after the death of Jesus, and we start creating this calendar, the church calendar, we got to do something. And so we get to Christ the King Sunday. It fit when it was established because there were kingdoms, kings and queens and princes and princesses, and that they understood that nature. We don't. How many of you have ever play the game Rock'em Sock'em Robots, or whatever that is. Yeah, Rock'em Sock'em Robots. Yeah. Well, that's kind of what our lives are like. We just finished the political season where it was Rock'em Sock'em Robots. Last night watching the news, I heard somebody say the 2020 election has just started with two primary candidates arriving in Iowa. Doesn't that just make you happy? Maybe we could be better off with a king. But only if the king understood their proper role. By the time the vision of the king came to Jesus, they had perverted that role into one who was going to slay the enemies, who was going to put to death those that the Israelites didn't like. I often tell people without laughing, because I believe it's true, that if we were all to keep the list of who's in heaven and who's not, ain't gonna be nobody there. You can tell my mom I put it that way. She doesn't like it when I say things that way. So if we keep the list, everybody's out. Deny that, if you would. And I'll tell you a story. One day a man was hanging on the cross, a man on his left, a man on his right, and a man on his left was deriding him, making fun of him, laughing at him, mocking him. He died. That's the end of the story. But the other one chastised him and corrected him and said, listen, we deserve what we're getting. Raise your hand if you're a sinner. If we were to get what we deserve, would be exactly what that guy got, his death. But God comes in grace. God comes to love us so much that he was willing to die that we could live. Raise your hand if you're a saint. You're a lot slower putting those hands up. I'll say it one more time. Raise your hand if you're a saint. Oh boy. When I used to teach down at Greenview University, I'd say this class here is a lot like confirmation. The only difference there is in confirmation, the pastor would just scowl at the door of your GPA is right there in my hand. Raise your hand if you're a saint. Yes. Come on. Simultaneously, right? Simultaneously saint and sinner. You are saints because God was willing to hang on a cross and die for you. You are a saint because God says, I am your God. You are a saint because God says, I am the ruler of this kingdom. I am your king. And in the words he said to the man hanging on his right, today you will be with me in where?
Paradise.
At seminary, one of my classmates asked Dr. David Teedy, who later became the president of the seminary, what does that mean? And David Teedy was a wonderful teacher. He looked at it for a moment and said, I don't know. All I know is Jesus said, today you will be with me. We focus on where? Why don't we latch on to with me, he said. Today, this Christ the King Sunday, we celebrate being with God who wants to be our King. Why? Because in the Old Testament, God says, I love you guys so much, I'm just willing to die for you. And it happens on a Friday afternoon at a place called the Skull, outside of the city of Jerusalem. God's Son, who comes as a lowly baby, dies because he loves you that much. Today, you will be with me in paradise. Only a king who is the King and Lord of paradise can say, you are with me. That is what this is all about. God is King. He is our royalty. He is our Savior. And he says to you, today, you will be with me in paradise. They missed it. Let us not miss it. And hang on to those words. And in our living, into our deaths, remember, we are never far from God. Amen. I would invite you to rise and turn to hymn number 389.
Amen.
We believe
in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we pray this day, we remember those that I announced at the beginning of the service, as well as Nancy Bishop, who is Randy and Sandy's sister-in-law, recovering from a stroke down in Florida. We'll include her in our prayers as well. With the people of God gathered here throughout the world, we offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation.
For Christ's church on earth, and for those who proclaim the good news of your reign, that all divisions cease, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For your creation in all its beauty, for water and land, plants and animals, and for those who advocate for the just use of the earth, that all creatures enjoy life abundant, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For government servant leaders, for those who provide justice and safety, and for those in war-torn places, that all be guided by the peace of the Lord, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For those traveling this week, for those gathered with family and friends, for protection from inclement weather, and for the body of Christ gathered here, let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
For the alienated, the sick and suffering, for those living with any disease, and for those in need of reconciliation, that God provide them with skilled medical practitioners and counselors. For Lois Wilson as she's returned home, and for Ann Erickson who now recovers at home. May they be blessed by your Spirit, which gently holds them together and gives them peace and strength. For Peggy Schenkel, as she rests at the hospice house, that doctors and nurses, family and friends may give her spirit joy as she lives with Christ and receives time at her home. For Nancy Bishop, as she recovers from her stroke, may she find your comfort and strength in you, O God, and may your Spirit guide and direct her healing back into wholeness. Let us pray.
And thanksgiving for all the saints who live their lives giving thanks to God and are now at rest, that their witness strengthen our confidence in the resurrection to eternal life. Let us pray.
Have mercy, O God.
Almighty God, you have promised to hear those who call upon your name. We commend all our spoken and silent prayers to you, trusting in your abundant mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I would invite you to be seated. And just a reminder, our ushers will stand one on each side and then you see the pledge sheet as well as time and balance sheets. And here, someplace in the center, we'll set the women's basket. Those of you who are members are welcome to have the thank offering box please placed right in there. You will not be ushered forward, so I would invite you to just do it as a spirit moves you. Amen. I would invite you to rise at this time. Let us pray. In your hands, Almighty God, we place ourselves, our minds, to know you, our hearts to love you,
our wills to serve you, for we are yours. Into your hands, our Savior, we place ourselves, receive us, and draw us after you, that we may follow your steps, abide in us, and enlighten us by the power of your reality.
Thank you.
scattered upon the hills will gather together to become one bread. So let your church be gathered together from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. For yours is the glory, in Jesus Christ, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for them to drink, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of our Lord and risen Savior, Jesus Christ, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Share in the inheritance of the saints. Come to the table prepared for you. You may be seated.
Thank you.
I'm not sure.
You have gathered your scattered flock again this day, feeding us richly with the food of paradise. Accompany us as we serve you all the days of our lives, and gather us with the saints at the end of our life, in the day of our death, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Lord.
Amen.
Receive this blessing. God who loves us, who gives us eternal consolation and good hope, comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. And the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
We turn to our Sunday song.
Thank you. with you.
Thanks be to God.